My name is Cindy. I am a summer box reviewer for Sabbatical Beauty. And tonight I am going to do my PM routine for everyone. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started. And if you guys have any questions, just ask them. I am on my phone tonight, so I might have to scroll through the comments on my phone, which might be a little difficult, but I will do my best to make it work. My internet is down, so we're on data on the phone with no computer. So hopefully this will work out okay. All right, so my first cleanse every night is the oil cleanser. So I'm gonna do that first, which is my favorite part of the day every day. I love oil cleansing, guys. Hi, Boone. And the nice thing about the summer box is it's really helped to clean out my pores. I used to have to do this for 20 minutes, guys, to get all the crap out of my pores, just because they were so congested. Probably just from neglect. When I had a child and after I had a child, I really just kind of, I didn't take very good care of my face. I really didn't. So when I started using Sabbatical Beauty, I really needed the products to help me clean out my pores. So I had a lot of what we call grits, which is the pores cleaning themselves out in like these lines that come out of your pores, basically just the congestion coming out. I had that for weeks and weeks. But it is almost gone now. So now when I do my oil cleanse, it really only takes me probably 5 minutes. And then I can move on to the next step instead of having to take 20 minutes to do it, because that's how long it took to get everything out of my face. So I have a stubborn guy over here. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to make him cooperate, but I can feel it. That's one of the things I love about oil cleansing, because it makes your face so smooth you can like really feel where there's a problem, where it may not be obvious otherwise, and it kind of helps you focus on it better. Does that make sense? I'm sure a lot of you guys use it too. The vacuum cleanser oil. Yeah, that's not gonna cooperate, I can tell. Maybe the detox mask will get it. So I just rub in the vacuum cleanser. And I always get under my jawline really good, because that's where I break out the worst. It used to be on my temples. Actually, when I started the summer box, I still had breakouts on my temples. And those have been gone since my second week using the summer box. It only took a week for them to get rid of them entirely. It's actually weird. I don't know if I had told you guys this before, but my breakouts have basically like moved down my face through the summer box review process. So like they started up here, and then they moved down to my temples, and then they moved down to my cheeks, and then they moved down to my chin and around my mouth, and now all those are gone. And I still get, I got one whenever I started my period, and then, but that was just the one. And it's like, it's almost gone now. I don't even know if you guys can see it. It's right there. It was big and ugly like 2 days ago. And now it's almost healed. And now the only place I get them is right under my jawline. And those are almost gone too. I don't think I have any breakouts right now. Except this one that I can feel. And I'm not even sure if that's active or if that's healing. But the ones under my jawline are all healing now, too. So I don't think I have anything coming out right now. So that's really exciting. Because my, hormonally, my cycle just started 2 days ago. So this is like my hot spot part of the month when I always break out really bad. So the fact that I was able to go through that whole week without craziness going on my face is pretty exciting. Because the hormonal acne is always the hardest part. That's always the biggest struggle. And that's usually all I get. So now I'm gonna get my water as hot as I can for my washcloth so that I can rinse off the vacuum cleansing oil. Alright, it takes a minute in my sink. I'm sorry, guys. Come on. There we go. I should have turned it on sooner. Alright. I'm gonna wash off my oil cleanser. Put this on my face. This is like my favorite part of the day, guys. I love the way this feels. It feels so nice putting a hot washcloth on your face. And then wiping everything off and seeing how clean it is. See? Alright, so that's the first cleanse in the evening. And then, so I use the detox mask 2 or 3 times a week. So most nights I would follow that with a bamboo foaming cleanser in the summer box. But tonight, on the nights I use the detox mask, it is my second cleanse. Hi, Mom! I'm washing my face in front of everybody tonight. How are you doing? So we just got done doing an oil cleanser, and now I'm gonna do the detox mask. Video won't play for me tonight. Oh no, my internet is down. So I'm using my data on my phone. Joy. Haha, that's your name, that's funny. I'm gonna catch the replay so I don't get interrupted. I got you there. Sometimes I have the option to watch lives and I don't because I know I'm gonna get interrupted 1,000 times and I'll be able to pay better attention if I wait until I'm able to actually, you know, give it a good watch. Sometimes for me the best time is when I'm at work, just while I'm getting stuff done. Alright, so the detox mask, you always gotta mix it up really well. All the, like, the sediment in the mask is always gonna settle to the bottom. I just used this a couple days ago and it's already settled, so you're gonna have to do it every time, so make sure that you do. Or it's gonna, you're gonna get all the, like, the oils at the top and you're not gonna get any of the sediment to do the exfoliating, and you don't want that, so. So, and that's the consistency of the detox mask, so let's go ahead and put it on. Now, I don't really use the spatula to put it all over my face, and the reason why, now it is nice to get it from point A to point B, though, without making a mess. Don't get me wrong, it definitely helps with that part. Ah! See? There's that, too. So you gotta be careful with this one. It does amazing things for your face, but it's messy, but that's okay. So don't try to put this on if you're not in your bathroom. So what I do after that is, this has all kinds of little, like, exfoliating, like, particles in it. I think probably from all the vegetables in it, and it feels so good to just rub it in when you put it on your face, and you're getting a lot of exfoliation when you do. And the detox mask doesn't really dry. It just wasn't really made that way. I don't think it has any clay in it. No, it doesn't have any clay in it, so that's probably why it doesn't dry. But if you put it on this way and you use it for the exfoliating, then it dries it most of the way just from applying it. And then you just kind of leave it on for a few minutes before you wash it off. And this really helps to get rid of all the dead cells from my face. So, what do you guys think? My husband calls this my monster mask. It makes him scared of me. So this is my Hulk monster mask that I use from the summer box. And it feels, I don't know how to explain it. It's almost like if you guys have ever done like a sugar scrub on your face before, it kind of feels like that whenever you put it on. Like it just feels, I don't know, like you can feel it getting rid of all the dead cells on your face. So I'm doing this because I promised you guys that I would apply the detox mask for you on my next video. So here we are. I kept my word. I don't make promises that I'm not gonna keep. Alright, so I'm done with the exfoliating part. And now I'm just gonna leave it alone. Rinse all this green stuff off my hands so I can actually touch things. In the meantime, I am gonna leave this on for a few minutes. So if you guys have any questions, now would be a good time to ask them. Hi, young mom. Your internet being crazy too? I have none. I have no internet. I just have cell phone service. Or I wouldn't have been able to do this at all tonight. So thank goodness for internet backup plans, right? Thank goodness for backups. I washed off my spatula. It comes nice and clean too. This thing cleans really easy. I really like that about it. Put the lid back on my detox mask. Every time you open the detox mask, you're gonna get a little bit of like leakage, so just be aware of that. And the only reason why I'm telling you that is because if you don't make sure you clean it in like whatever drawer or whatever you put it in, it might make a mess, so you might want to make sure you get everything back inside and then put the lid back on. And then get something to wipe it off before you put it away. Because I didn't the first couple times I used it, and then I realized there was green in my drawer. So just make sure you close it really tight and wipe off the edges when you're done, and you'll be fine. So this mask feels so good, guys. I love it. I don't. It's true. My mom says I don't make promises I don't keep. It's true. And I actually will get angry with people for trying to make me make promises that I know that I can't keep. Because you can't force somebody to make a promise. And if you do, you shouldn't. That's not right. No one should ever feel obligated to make a promise. Because it's important that it be sincere. Hi, Katie. Hey, told you I would do my detox mask tonight, so here it is. I just got done doing my oil cleanser, and then I washed that off, and then I massaged the detox mask in for a couple minutes, and now I'm just going to let it sit on for a few minutes before I finish the rest of my evening routine for you guys. So, do you guys have any questions while we're hanging out? Guess I can go ahead and get my evening routine ready. Let's see. This guy. Love the green. You like my Hulk mask, Mom? It's pretty. Green is my favorite color. I mean, I don't know if I want my face to be green, but it is my favorite color. Looks go green. So, oh yeah, tonight is a pouring gray night. I'm gonna be honest, guys. I use a lot of serums at night. But, most of them are either to do work on your pores. I do most of that stuff at night, like, you know, your treatments. And then, like the anti-aging serum, I use that at night. It does. Katie asks if it feels like it's doing anything. It really does. It feels, I think, I think the word would be like a tingle. Like the, I wish I knew which thing it was that was giving you the sensations. Oh, it has rose hip powder in it. Maybe that's where the, and the spinach powder. Maybe that's where the, like the manual exfoliation in it is. But yeah, you definitely feel it when you have it on. It, it's like a tingling feeling. Like you can feel, you definitely can feel it working. But I don't mean that in, like it's not a strong sensation, I don't think, at all. It's just a very light, almost like a heating up, you know, but just like a, just a very, very little heating up of your skin. Like you can feel it working. So, yeah, I really like the detox mask, and I have, I can't tell now. I was going to show you guys how much I have left, but I can't. I mixed it up, and now you can't see the line. Now I'm curious. If I open it again, I'm going to have to clean the edges again. That's weird. I took the lid off, and now suddenly you can see how much is left. There we go. I can hold it. Why can't I hold it level? Is it me, or is it the phone? There we go. That's how much I have left. So that is actually a little bit more than half. I think I have more left than I thought I did. I thought I was almost out of it. I'm not. And I've used this mask. Let's see. We're at the beginning of, or no, we're at the end of week 4. And I also used it in the pre-week too. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I've used it 10 times, and I still have more than half of the jar left, so that's pretty good. This is going to last a while. This should last for the summer, at least most of the summer. I'd say it'll last me at least until mid-July, and that's constant use, so if I continue to use it as much as I have been. It makes me visualize that you're on a stakeout hiding in the bushes. That's I look like I'm wearing camo. That's funny. It makes me think of that movie. Oh man. There's too many movies like that. I'm not going to be able to remember which one it is. I don't know. One of the movies with the guy hiding in the bushes with a machine gun. I don't know which one. I can't remember. But yeah, that image of the camouflage person. It does feel really good though. I love this mask. I wish I knew how long I'd had it on. I have no idea. I wish that my phone showed me what time it is while I'm on here, and it doesn't. So I have no idea how long we're in. And of course I don't have a clock. But yeah, so in the evenings I do like treatments for my pores, like stuff that I want to reduce my pores and work on my breakouts. And then the anti-aging serum I use at night, and I use a couple hydrating serums and something for evening. And then after that it's just hydration, like creams after that. So Katie said she masked with blueberries and cream. I love that mask so much. It's the best moisturizing mask ever. I've been on for 22 minutes. Oh, really? Okay, well, I can wash the mask off now then. It's been on long enough. That's long enough. I'm not looking forward to washing this off in front of you guys, because it's hard. But I promise I would. 7:24 mountain time. Is that like Kansas? Is that long? Minnesota? No. I don't know mountain time. I'm lucky I know California time. The washcloth nice and hot to make this as easy as possible. And the biggest thing about this mask, guys, when you wash it off, be careful. Don't get it in your eyes. It hurts. just like most of the masks, you know, anything masking wise, you don't want to get it in your eyes. So I'm probably going to do that first, just to be safe, to make sure I don't accidentally get it up there. Yeah, that's a good idea. So if you get it up under your eyes while you're scrubbing, make sure you get it out from underneath there before you wash off the rest, because you might accidentally push it into your eyes, and it hurts. You don't want to get it in there. So I'm going to wash it all off. I think doing this in front of you guys makes me better at it, because I don't usually have this easy of a time getting it off. At least the phone data is holding up for the video. That's good. I guess that means my data's pretty consistent. Make sure I get all the green out of my hairline, because I don't want to carry it to bed with me. Bye. My mom is signing out. Good night, Mom. Okay. I think I got it all off. Yep. Alright, so I'm clean. So that's my second cleanse. So that is my double cleanse on a detox night. And then after that, I use the Maple Essence toner. I use the strawberry toner in the mornings. I don't use it twice a day, because twice a day seemed to be too much for me. How often do I hang out with my mom? Well, she lives about two and a half hours away. So I only see her about once a month most of the time. Unfortunately, I wish she was closer. So about once a month, we got to see each other a couple times last month because my niece had a play one weekend and then we went camping the following weekend, but we don't usually get to see each other that often. So I did the cleansing oil followed by the detox mask, and then I did Maple Essence toner, and then I used Piper's Peat on just on areas with stubborn milia and pores, and I only use a couple drops of that one. And you gotta be careful with peat, because for some reason that one likes to fall over, so I always make sure it's sitting somewhere very level. Yeah, I wish I saw her more often, Katie. I'm so jealous of girls that, especially when I was going through my pregnancy, I was so jealous of the girls who had their moms like either next door or down the road or 15 minutes away, because I was like, I want my mom. Especially when I was pregnant, it was really hard having her that far away. So Piper's Peat, and then I have a tester serum. It's called Prickly Pear, which I actually wrote it on there and it's rubbing off. But it's Prickly Pear Serum. It's a tester product right now, so it may or may not go into production, but it's supposed to be good for, it's supposed to help with acne. I also read that Prickly Pear is supposed to help with dark circles, so I've been putting it under there too, just in case. And then I've been putting it on my breakout areas. It's like a really thin serum. Like peat. So peat and prickly pear. And then every other night I use Dorian Gray. And I use 3 drops of this one. Maybe. Oh, it's empty. There's number 3. And then I use that on just anywhere I have signs of aging. So For me, that's the labial lines and the forehead. And just right around my eyes. And that's it. Luckily, that's the only places I have right now. Hopefully it'll stay that way for a while. I have noticed that the nasolabial lines have gotten a lot better since I started using the Summer Box, and I actually think it's the strawberry toner that's helped to make everything work so much better. Yeah, Katie, my mom and I are really close. Definitely. I'm very grateful for having a good relationship with my mom, because I know that not everybody has that. And now I'm putting on Marine. I use Marine morning and evening just because I found it to do a really good job to keep any areas I have that like to dry out, like especially my cheeks. It really helps to prevent them from doing that. It makes a big difference. So Piper's Pete, Prickly Pear, and Marine Serum, which is one of my favorite serums. Oh, and Dorian Gray, which is still over here. And then I use a couple drops of Hydra. I guess I use a lot in the evenings when I... If you guys have any questions, please feel free to ask. And Hydra I use. Same thing in the places where I dry out, and... But I only use this one at night. I used to use it during the day until it started getting warm outside, and now I only use it in the evenings. And Hydra is kind of my, like, instead of coconut... because I used to use Hydra during the day, and Hydra's thicker. So Hydra is not really one that you want to use during the day in the summer. Once it starts to get like hot and muggy outside, unless you're going to use it by itself. I know some girls like to do that, but whenever it started to get warmer, I swapped out Hydra for coconut. Right before the Summer Box, actually. I had just started it a couple weeks before that. Because they're both really good at helping with acne and balancing and moisture and hydration and oil control all at the same time. So that's a nice thing to know if you guys didn't know that. I think that Hydra and coconut are really good ones to swap out with each other for the different seasons. Like if you really like Hydra in the winter, you're probably gonna really like coconut in the summer. They're really good swapping buddies, I think. Or for morning and evening, like if you have Hydra and, like I do, and you don't want to stop using it like I do, then you can switch it to the evening instead. I just used a couple drops of Pearl on top of everything. Pearl helps to this was in the spring box. That helps to even out your skin tone. It helps with brightening. And I believe it also helps with oil control. And then the last serum I use in the evenings is Magic Dragon. And that one I just use under my eyes. And just if I have, because it helps with healing as well, I use it on just any areas that need to heal. Like I have a couple acne spots that are being stubborn, so... that need to finish healing. And then I just use whatever is left on my lips. So that's all the serums. I know that's a lot. I'm sorry, guys. And then I use Glow just on the dark spots. And then I have... Actually, I got this idea from Marissa. I spray this spatula with rubbing alcohol. That's all this is. Just to make sure that the next time I use it, that it's sanitary. It's weird using you guys as my mirror. So this is Glow Pressed Serum, which helps. It has a lot of vitamin C. And it helps to brighten dark spots. And I have a few of those, like, here and there. None of them are really large. It's just that they're there. And then that one is an acne scar from last month. In the middle of my cheek, which is really weird. I don't usually get breakouts on my cheek, but I had one random one decide to show up in the center of my cheek last month. And it left a spot, and it's still healing. So the glow... But the glow has definitely helped to make it less noticeable a lot faster, so that's nice. And then after the serums, I use the anti-aging eye gel oil, which is really good for softening and anti-aging around the eyes. It's a really nice soft oil for your eyes. It's really gentle. I don't know, I just love it. And then I just kind of try to rub it into my eyelashes because it's supposed to help with eyelash growth too. And my eyebrows. And use whatever's left on my lips. And then Lush Beauty Oil. A few drops of this. I was using Red Wine Press Serum at night until this week. But I've been using a tester product, Jade Gel Cream, which is almost gone now. And I was just having a really hard time applying it over top of a Red Wine Press Serum. So, I took that out in the evenings this week. But the Jade Gel is almost gone, so we'll probably go back into my routine next week. So, that was Blush Beauty Oil. And then, a little bit of After Sun. Which, I did get some sun today, so I really think I need this aloe-based moisturizer today. I think I really need it. And it just cools you down so much. I love this stuff, guys. It feels so nice. Is everybody still here? My phone came up with a warning that said I had a low network connection and then it went away. And then after sun, I use the Jade Gel Cream, which is a tester, which is, it's almost gone. Which is, it's kind of similar in consistency to similar in consistency to the Donkey Gel sleeping pack, so that's why so I've been using it instead of it this week. Just because it seems to be helping with pore reduction a little bit. Just full disclosure so you guys know that's going on too. But it's almost gone. So it's usually either the Jade Gel or the Donkey Gel cream. And if it's not the Jade Gel, then I use Red Wine Press Serum before I put on After Sun and blush. And that's it. That is my entire evening routine right now. So I hope that was helpful for you guys.